Hi, I'm Matias Gonzalez. I'm a creative developer that have built websites for companies like Vercel and Daylight. And this is the course about building award-winning marketing websites. In this course, we're going to learn about different approaches to build JavaScript and CSS animations. We're also going to use GSAP to trigger those animations when the user scrolls through our site. And finally, we'll use Blender to build a 3D product tour and embed that into our websites. Go and build amazing experiences on the web. We will start by learning one animation library called GSAP. GSAP is a really, really useful library to add animations to our website and tag those animations to the scroll. It's been around forever, and it has a lot of utilities that we can use. So how does GSAP work? Let's start by animating this text in. So we have our H1 here, and I'm going to go ahead and add a use effect. And what I want to do is to grab this element and animate from an opacity 0 into opacity 1. Let's start with something real simple. So I can do gsap.from, and I can just grab my class here to select it using this class. And then I would say opacity 0. So the way this works is, I need to import GSAP first. So the way this works is that GSAP is going to grab our object and it says, hey, what's the current opacity of this object? It's 1 by default. So what we'll do is we said, hey, I want to animate this object from opacity 0 into its current state. So for example, let's do a different thing. Let's do x 200. It will animate from x 200, so to the default position. So it will start to the right and then it will animate into its default state. What happens if I want to animate something to some value? So I want to start in its default value and then I want to like animate it to x 200, so I just can use gsap2. So this way I can tell gsap, hey, grab this element and change its default value to this number. So when I load, yeah, it will start in its default position and then it will move into x 200. There is a way to tell GSAP, hey, animate from this value to this value, and it doesn't really care its default value, and it's from 2. So with from 2, we can actually specify, I want to animate from x minus 200 into x 200. So it will set the first value to this, and then it will animate into this other value. So if we go ahead and reload, we can see how it's like moving from the first value into the second one. This is awesome, but we have our first performance issue here, and is that, as we know, when we use effect, we usually have to clean up whatever we are doing. So we can return a function. This function is going to be executed whenever this component gets unmounted. So if I get away from this page, this function is going to run. And why I'm pointing this out is because let's do, for example, on update. What this function is doing is that every time GSAP updates the value, it will run this callback function. So I can just debug something. So I'm going to just log update here. So if I go back in here and open the console and refresh, I can see how it's like running the update callback. let's actually make this animation way longer by adding a duration of 10 seconds. And let's actually go ahead and start the animation and get away from this into another experiment. So I'm in a different page and I can see that the update is still running. So my animation didn't stop because I am multi the component. It's like still running there. So the first thing that I want to actually do is to clean up this animation. I want to stop it. So by the way, every GSAP animation is called a twin. So it's animating from one value to another. That's one twin. So we can grab this twin and just revert it. And what this will do is it will kill the animation and it will reset every value to its default state. So if I go ahead and enter again, I will see that as soon as I leave the page, it will stop the animation. And if I enter back, it will play again. I want this element to like stick on the view and place this animation as I scroll. And if I scroll back, I want this animation to play on reverse. So first, let's actually add a scroll trigger. So scroll trigger. And we want this animation to be triggered by this container. So since we already have a reference, we can just use the reference directly. The current. Also, let's add the markers. True. And then let's say that it will start at the top and then it will end when the bottom of the screen reaches the end of this container. So end, bottom, bottom. And also what I'm going to do is right now this is like one screen height. So I will make it like 300 view per height, for example. So that I have some actual space to scroll. So right now this is very similar to the previous example. As soon as this is on view, it will just play the animation. So what I want to do is actually it to follow the scroll. So there is a property on the scroll trigger. Actually, I messed this up. This should be the trigger property inside of scroll trigger, and then these are all properties inside of scroll trigger. Here you go. Okay, so we are playing our animation as soon as we enter. So I want my animation to follow my scroll, and there is a property called scrub for that. What this will do is my animation will exactly follow my scroll progress. And as I can see, like it is playing, it is working, but like it's getting away from the screen. I just want it to be like pinned on the screen. So we could use something like CSS like sticky. Sometimes like if you have more elements on the same div, you might have problems with sticky. So GSAP already has a solution to stick a div to the screen. And it's a pin. So if I set like pin to true, how pin works is we need to tell GSAP like what element do we want to pin into the screen. So in this case is this div that I have right here. I'm gonna add an outline to debug like what this element is actually. So border, let's add the border red. Classic debug border red. So I have this element. This is what I want to get pinned into the screen. And then this larger container is like the scroller. So let's actually add a class name to it called
pin. And let's target this element on the pin property. So if I refresh, as soon as the animation starts, this element is going to stay on the screen. It's going to play our animation. And as soon as it ends, it's going to like unpin it from the screen. We do need to animate a value that we're going to pass down into a component. So this time we're not animating any CSS property or variable. We're just animating some object that we need to pass down. So the way to go about that is that you can create a reference, for example. So const progress ref is equal to use ref and start that as zero. So GSAP can actually animate like anything that we want. So we can actually animate this reference. So let's do timeline.to. And let's target our reference. And let's, instead of like animating like opacity, we can animate the current value. So let's actually debug this to understand what's happening. I'm going to say on update. And I'm going to do console.log. Progress ref.current. So every time I scroll, this reference is going to be animated, and GSAP is going to animate the current property. So it's actually going to animate the value inside of that reference. So if I save and I scroll, I should see that as I scroll up, it's getting to zero, and then I scroll down and it gets closer and closer to one. So now we can use this value on a different component to actually trigger the animation. Let's actually grab the progress ref and say progress is equal to this reference. Let's now go into the scroll sequence and type the property. So progress, instead of being a number, is going to be react.ref object with a number inside. So right now, instead of directly referencing the progress, I can just reference the progress.current value. So if I refresh and I scroll, I can see how it progresses. We do have a little issue, and it's that the previous frame is not being cleared, because by default, every time we render into a canvas, it already has something drawn, and it's not going to clear that by default. So I need to tell the canvas on every frame, hey, delete every pixel that you draw before and just render new pixels into the screen. So the way we do that is we grab the context of our canvas, so context, and we set clear rect. And this telling the canvas, hey, grab these coordinates and just delete whatever you have on them. So it's I'm going to clear from the corner of the canvas all the way to the complete width of it, and then from also the top of the canvas to the complete height. So it's going to clear the canvas completely. Oh, So Ctrl F here. Okay. So now if I refresh and I scroll, I can see how the sequence progresses as I scroll.